would now like to invite the ministers to exchange the documents.
Link bilateral agreement has no provision for a suspension, but in the spirit of bilateral cooperation, Singapore has given the Malaysian request serious consideration. After several rounds of discussions, we have reached a mutually acceptable arrangement on the way forward. I thank the officials from both countries for burning their long weekend finalizing the supplementary agreement. Later today, the exchange of documents will formalize our agreement on the suspension of the construction of the RTS project up to the end of September 2019. As part of this suspension, Malaysia will reimburse Singapore for the abortive costs incurred as a result of suspension. During the suspension period, Malaysia will consider if it intends to proceed with the RTS link project as it is, or Malaysia can also propose changes to the project scope, which Singapore will give any such changes due consideration. We hope that the RTS link project will resume at the end of the suspension period, either in its current form as prescribed in the bilateral agreement, or incorporating any project scope changes that both sides agree on during the suspension. If not, the RTS link project will be deemed to have been terminated by Malaysia, and Malaysia will reimburse Singapore for the costs we have incurred in fulfilling our RTS link obligations till now. This decision to suspend the RTS link project will affect LTA contractors and bidders involved in the project, as well as SMRT, which is Singapore's joint venture partner for the RTS link operator.
First of all, we have had a short meeting just now with Minister Koh. I told Minister Koh that today indeed is a very special day for me because the 21st of May marks my first anniversary as a minister. I was sworn in as a minister last 21st of May. And in the past 1 year, both of us have met 6 times. That shows the closeness and the importance of our working relationship. And I'd like to thank Mr. Koh and the officials involved who have worked tirelessly for this signing. After rounds of discussion, Malaysia and Singapore have reached a mutually acceptable agreement. The signing of the side letters for the RTS link agreement today formalizes the deferment of the RTS link project until 30th of September 2019. We appreciate Singapore's support and understanding on the challenges we face in implementing the RTS link project. We recognize the urgent need to alleviate traffic congestions at Johor Bahru Singapore Causeway, which facilitates about 300,000 crossings daily, affecting approximately 250,000 Malaysians working in Singapore. The agreement will allow us some time to explore other affordable and sustainable solutions to address traffic congestions at the border. These include new initiatives such as improvement to the physical infrastructure at the border, review of interboundary policies and regulations, and enhancing the quality of cross-border services. Malaysia will bear the agreed cost in suspending the RTS Link project if by 30th September 2019, Malaysia does not proceed with the RTS Link project. Malaysia will also bear the agreed cost incurred by Singapore in fulfilling the RTS Link bilateral agreement. Let us continue to find new ways that could still meet the objective of providing an affordable, efficient, and practical transport connectivity between the two countries. Anyhow, even though that we are suspending the RTS Link project, but in the next few months or so, we will work very hard to ensure that we can find solutions, find better approaches, and both of us really hope that we can proceed with this RTS Link project. Thank you.
Thank you. Malaysia will consider if it intends to proceed with the RTS Link project as it is, or Malaysia can also propose changes to the project scope, which Singapore will give any such changes due consideration. We hope that the RTS Link project will resume at the end of the suspension period, either in its current form as prescribed in the bilateral agreement, or incorporating any project scope changes that both sides agree on during the suspension
period. 新加坡政府也同意展延这个日本链到9月30号，所以今天我们是签署这个合约，那么把这个计划呢展延到9月30号来做出一个最后的决定。那么在这个过程呢，我们都希望呢能够有一个空间来重新讨论这个 RTS 这个方向。最重要的就是我们希望把这个成本可以降低，因为如果成本降低的话，以后的这个票价就可以降低。 所以这个是我们最大的考量，所以我们希望呢，两方可以在未来的这个几个月，我们重新讨论过，那么找出一个最好的方案，来确保这个 RTS 可以继续。那么我们都知道，马来西亚人民，特别是在新山的，住在新山，在新加坡工作的马来西亚人民呢，都是非常的希望，这个计划可以继续。所以我们在针对这一点呢，我们也非常了解。 他们的这个期望，所以我们都非常努力，都希望呢把这个计划能够继续。